Welcome back, everybody, here to the Joint Data Masters, powered by Gigabyte as well as AMD. Big thanks to them, because of them, we get to have awesome games like this one. DK versus eHome, China versus China, to see who can come out on top. eHome looking in superb form. DK looking a little bit shaky right now, but maybe they can get their cool, calm, collective thoughts together and come back now here in game number two. A man who knows the way these guys think is my co-commentator. He's a man from the international. He's a man who is international. He basically speaks English, lived in Germany, was from China. Everything we need in a co-commentator. Welcome back, Slash. Yes, I did give him volume. And he's also not here. Oh, well, everything you need in a co-commentator bar his physical presence. But he'll be back here in a couple of moments' time. As everyone knows from our last game, DK versus eHome. eHome, they are one game up currently. If it is enough to take it through, we will have to wait and find out. DK, they have themselves Lashrak as well as Champ Band out. eHome removing out Prophet as well as Lycan and Brewmaster. So basically, similar bands. No, none of these guys are really going to be appearing through this game. And, well, we get to go through our next stage. And do they give the Invoker pickup back up again? Or do we go down another path? How do we really want to try and run with this? DK, the choice is yours, man. We saw from eHome in the last game a very aggressive kind of style. The Batrider picked work for them, but they got a good start. That was the reason why. And it sounds like Slash is on the way back, which is a very, very good thing, because Slash managed to miss the introduction of the cast, which is always the most epicest thing we ever do. Slightly epic. But we are back now here in the draft stage. Slash, man, are you back with me? No. There'll be a no. No. Slash will be back here in a moment. I know, there's always an easy thing to do. That makes it easy, so I don't have to keep on guessing for him. But DK, they're taking their sweet time right now for this third ban. I think RNTK has been looking at PGG a little bit too much, and they're going to ban out the SK. So SK is now removed by eHome, so they're wanting to remove out... Actually...
What the hell? Sorry.
Did you just have your microphone banned? Or you just like bad timing? SK is the final ban out from DK. I'm wondering if that's going to like indicate the DK with these first two picks looking at a Broodmother.
Possible. I say it's not impossible in a sense. And yes, I do apologize for missing the introduction every single time.
You fail! You're okay.
It seems to be incredibly unfortunate, yes. 5 seconds
remaining. yeah, but you can at least now see the drop, so as you can see so far, all the bans out. Darkseer is the one who gets to get through the pool, and eHome will pick him up.
Let's see if DK want that Invoker again, because apparently eHome were just not concerned with DK having the Invoker, really.
Well, the Invoker still caused the trouble. What gave eHome the advantage in the last game was that tri-lane that worked for them.
Yes.
It was the aggressive tri-lane versus the tri-lane of DK, and that's what hurt the most. This time around, though, I got a funny feeling that it's probably the main reason why eHome picked up Darkseer. The funny feeling that DK want to try and go split push. So they can go with Enchantress down one lane, then grab Shadow Shaman. But the Broodmother was going to be a big pickup to grab for that one. That's the reason why I think SK was taken out. But Darkseer being picked up causes trouble, and they are actually going to grab up at least one of my heroes and one of yours. So Shadow Shaman, as well as the Invoker, Pugnone ES, instant pickups from eHome.
Instant pickups. eHome wanted it.
These guys are prepared, man.
They were so prepared. They're so prepared for this. And I think that's very strong. Pugnone is so strong against Shadow Shaman. If you drop the wards while there's a ward around, you will die as Shadow Shaman. Basically, you lose around half of your hit points. It's so annoying. And Anti-Mage will be the pickup. And from DK, basically thinking that they will now ban out the counters in the next two sets of ban wards. Lada should be banned. I should imagine that. It would be very surprised me if they did not. Mm-hmm.
That's thought it'd be a good one to take out. And I'm not quite sure if Anti-Mage Rikimaru would be the final ban out, but just someone who's probably going to screw with anybody who will screw with the Anti-Mage. In fact,
Shadow Demon as well. They will need to ban on Shadow Demon.
Just want to throw another curveball your way. What if eHome try and pick up Broodmother right now?
5 seconds. What if eHome pick up Broodmother? Not too bad. It wouldn't be too bad for them, to be honest.
Because that would get pretty simple farm. And
why would eHome ban out Shadow Demon?
Considering he's the counter to Anti-Mage.
Just they banned their own counter.
DK banned the fruit.
What is this?
Hang on, remember that ATOD tournament we did, the reverse drive competition? That's what we're doing in this last Age of Bands.
Oh man, how could I even forget that?
No, we're forgetting that. The grand final never happened. I'm just saying.
The grand final was...
Grand final never happened. We never got to play the final. It never happened.
Oh yeah, no. There was a certain cow in the final, I think.
That's not a nice way to talk about my mother.
Oh, that was... I didn't say that. That was your own. You started it, so I wasn't even going to say that. I was going to say that there was a certain Chicago bull charging all people around the map and then dying on the way. But...
We just get to limit ourselves to one mother joke per cast, and I think I just spent mine. We're going to ban out Lich, which is a nice thing to do. Gonna be banned.
The reason why they would ban up the Shadow Demon would be they don't want to pick him, but on the other hand, if they give it to DK, it's very powerful with that combination, and they will ban up the Slaughter, very wisely.
By the way, guys, I apologize, but I don't know why, but the ads were all of a sudden just started automatically running. We never run them intentionally during any part of the match at all. Draft pauses, anything like that, we will not run them. But for some reason, the ads just automatically started running. So I apologize to those people who are currently going to go through ads. Hopefully you'll hear this in the breaks between the ads.
Yes, indeed. Let's see what they want to do to counter that anti-mage. 5 seconds. I'm thinking that Borfling will be a good option.
Just replicate him and just turn him against himself.
Yes.
That'd be one way to do it.
You can either try to out-carry the anti-mage, or you can completely screw up his other teammates. There are two possibilities.
Out-carry? Well, you want to try and bring back the days of Faceless Void? Faceless Void or Rikimaru?
How about Vacuum into Chronosphere? You ever thought about that?
That could actually work quite nicely.
Yes, it could actually work very nicely.
That's actually really lead. And then you add the Pugna Blast, and if ES or his Ener Fissure, just keep that sun going, and then Echo Slam and Mail to Death. Yeah, that'll work.
Windrunner's
the pickup. How do we forget about our lovely Ranger? Radiant team pick. But how's she going to go into the lanes? At this point, it almost feels like Windrunner's going to be our solo mid.
I think Pugna will be the solo mid.
Well, I would assume that as well, but... Windrunner being picked up when Darkseer's already up, it kind of means either Darkseer goes jungle, Windrunner goes bot, Pugna in towards the mid, Earthshaker support, and somebody with a lot of DPS on that top lane right clicker.
10 seconds remaining. Why have you thought about that Windrunner as a support?
Well, she could do that.
If she is a support, then it would make sense. So Windrunner, Earthshaker supporting a certain hero that they haven't picked up yet on top lane. Pugna, mid, Darkseer, solo bot.
But if Anti-Mage is going to head down towards the bottom lane, you may as well throw the Darkseer down there, because he's going to have a lot better time. Windrunner. Oh, yeah, that's going to throw Windrunner. Yeah, you're right. That's actually right. Darkseer should be on that bottom lane against Anti-Mage. Either that or they throw ES, Windrunner, and someone else down there.
CM, Anti-Mage lane, Inc. Mid. They want a dual mid.
Yeah. In that case, Windrunner can go bottom, and Pugna can stay mid. But then again, Pugna can pop. That CM stun then at level 2 had the Nova stun, AM blinks up, burns, and kills. That's the death of Pugna, unless he has support.
Well, we have the best bodyguard in the game in the form of Earthshaker.
That is true, but you don't want to waste him there. Like, you'd more want to throw him on the bottom. Where?
Nice.
OD.
Good counter. Good counter. Actually, people seem to think about it. It is a very double-edged sword. Outworld Destroyer is a very good counter to Anti-Mage because it's Arcane Orb, first of all, it's pure damage. So it goes through the spell sheet of Anti-Mage. It's not reduced, first of all. Second, at the same time, Anti-Mage kind of needs to burn mana for his ultimate to be effective. But through that essence aura that Destroyer has got, he will constantly be at full mana. So it will not do much to it. And the second, and thirdly, Mantis Star on Anti-Mage, it's not going to do much either because Venomancer. He one-shots illusions.
Venomancer is our final one for DK. It's counter-push with a little bit of options to push down some tier 1 towers to buy time for AM to farm and become OP. And then DK can win. And with the farm that Burning will be capable of achieving, I'm looking forward to seeing just when that Battle Fury appears. That's going to be my big question.
If you don't play correctly, around minute 22, maybe.
If they play correctly. If they don't play correctly, we might even see it at... the fastest we've been seeing it of recent times is about 13, 14 minutes. And 11. It's 11?
It's 11 minutes. That was the fastest we've seen. Forgot who it was, though.
It was probably Waga, because I know Enfu just keep running that lineup nonstop. They run the CM, AM, middle lane. Get some blood, get some easy kills.
They say it's a huge amount of delay at the moment.
Okay, so we're going to have ourselves a quick remake, because we are still on the Singaporean server, so that's one of our problems while we're on the Singaporean servers. You do still have that little bit of a delay, so a very, very quick remake. Hopefully we'll be okay when we get back inside the game. We would be playing on Shanghai servers, but at this point Valve is having some issues with their servers down there. In fact, looks like a lot of people... Nope, there is no update from Valve yet. So, we might actually have ourselves a very, very short break for this game until we get rehosted and back up again. Stick around, guys. Back here in a moment.